circumcision, and there's certainly a lot of different opinions on this topic. And you know, some people are all for it, some people are for circumcision, some people are not. Now, I certainly think, David Gonzo penis, that's got to be scary. Yes, I've seen those in like pictures and stuff, but I've never encountered one of my own. It would be very, very hard. Hey, Ken, nice to see you. Thanks for coming out to the show, Ken Boggle. Nice to see you in the chat room there. Thanks for hanging out. Anyway, so the next question is about, like I was saying, is about circumcision versus non-circumcision. Now, when it comes to penises, I don't, you know, I personally like either. It just depends, you know. I don't care if it's circumcised or not circumcised. To me, it doesn't matter. I think they both are can be hot, you know, so it doesn't really matter to me at all. But some people just cannot stand uncircumcised penises, and they think they're gross or whatever. And other people think that they're hot and sexy. So it just depends on a personal, you know, personal preference. But when it comes to the reason people get circumcised, generally, first of all, most people, when the circumcision first came about, was because, you know, most of like Middle Eastern cultures, or most not Middle Eastern cultures, Israeli cultures, like Judaism, whatever, you know, as part of giving your part to God as a male or whatever. It was part of their tradition. So they would circumcise everybody in the Jewish tradition. And eventually in the United States, circumcision didn't even come about really until like around the 30s or 40s. I think it was the 40s or 50s, something like that, when it became sort of a more commonplace practice. And because they said it was for sanitation or sanitary reasons or for health reasons, whatever, which is really ridiculous, because as long as you're cleaning yourself, it's not going to be any harder to clean a circumcised penis than it would be a non-circumcised one. And then towards the past, since the 90s and actually 2000s, I'm sorry, 2000s to now, it's gone down, declined slowly, 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 the number of circumcisions being performed. So you'll begin to see the generation we have now to have more less circumcision going on in their groups than those that are going on elsewhere. So basically, the people when they're in their 40s, people who are now in their 20s and their 40s, 20 years from now, most of them are a large majority will be not circumcised. So I don't know what you guys feel about it one way or the other, if you prefer one or the other, but you can let me know. So that's the penis talk for tonight. I want to talk a little bit about that, since we mentioned it briefly on the 5x5 show earlier when I was talking on their show. I wanted to say what I wanted to say about it, since we didn't have very long to talk about it. So anyway, I'm going to come back in a minute, talk about the t-shirt thing, and also talk about some other stuff. So I'll be right back after this. Well, if I can find the song, here we go. Be right back.
Meet me at the ice cream truck. I'll buy you an ice cream. I'll whip up my drumstick. That will make your eyes gleam. Lick it up quick before it melts on the floor. I got it. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Give me some more. Okay. Meet me at the ice cream truck. I'll buy you an ice cream. I can test on my luck. You can play on my team. Let's do the banana split on the dance floor. Got it. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Give me some more. Okay, I met him at the schoolyard round 2:45. We went out for cheeseburgers with extra cheese. I get my friend's fries, crispy ketchup on the side. And when it comes to dessert, this is how I ride. I said, meet me at the ice cream truck. I'll buy you an ice cream. I'll whip up my drumstick. That will make your eyes gleam. Lick it up quick before it melts on the floor. I got it. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Give me some more. Okay. You know where to find me from. Made it to I'm on the sidewalk, chilling, looking all kinds of fly. Sometimes I get low, sometimes I get high. I like rainbows, sprinkles on my ice cream pie. Yeah, right! Meet me at the ice cream truck. I'll buy you an ice cream. I'll whip up my drumstick. That will make your eyes gleam. Lick it up quick before it melts on the floor. I got it. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Give me some more. Okay, meet me at the ice cream truck. I'll buy you an ice ice cream. I can test on my luck. You can play on my team. Let's do the banana split on the dance floor. Got it. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Give me some more. Okay. Relax, take it easy. Check it when you see me. I'm chilling with an iced tea. Watermelon iced tea. Relax, take it easy. Check it when you see me. I'm chilling with an iced tea. Watermelon iced tea.
Okay, so we're back. Yes, as I was saying in the chat room, when it comes to uncircumcised penises, I think they're just as hot to me as, or sometimes hotter than the cut ones, because basically that's the way, first of all, God was meant for penis to look like. But there are some like, I don't know what's happening. I'm doing everything I'm supposed to be doing here. Hello, can you still hear me or what? Can you hear me or not? I don't know what the fucking deal is, but it's beginning to piss me off. If you can't hear me because I'm talking and all of a sudden you guys say the sound's going out. Okay, I don't know why, but my fucking internet is like blazing speed, so there's no reason this should be happening. It's pissing me off. But anyway, what I was gonna say is I was going to do the I saw I wanted to do the, well, for some reason, since I upgraded, and I'm saying the word upgraded here, I upgraded my internet to 50 megabytes per second download speed and like 6 megabytes upload, which is really fast. So this is, it should not be happening. This didn't happen with my slower internet at all. But every once in a while, it seems like it drops for some reason. Just for some reason, just drops the connection. And I don't know if they're throttling my bandwidth or what they're doing, but I'm going to begin to get really pissed off. So anyway, yes, it was overloaded with penis chat, Ken. That must be what it is. I couldn't handle it. But what I was going to say is, as I said before, I was going to do the t-shirt thing today. And the caller who answered the trivia question, the gay trivia question, correctly in 30 seconds or less, was going to win a free Off Limits Show t-shirt, which you can see at offlimitsshow.com if you want to buy yours, which I'm sure you do. But you can win one for free. I'm going to do several of them. That's just the first one I've done, which is my little tagline that I do, you know, which is liberal, irreverent, and oh, really, really gay. So you probably want to be a gay person who's very proud to wear that shirt if you're gonna buy it or you want to win it. But I'm gonna do several more that don't have that on there that are just gonna have the logos or whatever on it. I'm also going to do some other stuff as well. Giveaways on the show coming up in the next few months and stuff of that nature. Different shows, different giveaways for different shows. The Game Ass Show will have some, and then the Brain Purge Show, and then the Off Limits Show. So it just depends. But I'm trying to get people to call into the show because I am a call-in show and I need people to call in. Unfortunately, because this has not been cooperating with me tonight, I wasn't able to set up the show to take calls tonight. I had it set up that way, and then something happened, of course, and I wasn't able to. So as long as I can get that to work, what I'm going to have to do, I think, is actually get a mixer board, because which I can get for like $80, I think, on eBay or even, you know, whatever, even brand new. And I can get it, and then I can hook up my actual phone to take calls and use that number for calls instead of Skype. And then I won't have this issue where I can't connect to the show that way. I can use the actual switchboard from Spreaker, which is almost always works perfectly, except for a minute ago, obviously. And actually use the phone for phone calls, and it'll actually pipe those phone calls through the Spreaker switchboard. So that's what I'm planning to do that anyway, instead of doing it the way I've been doing it, because the software thing is just sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. And so I think if I have the hardware instead, it'll be better. So I think I'm going to do that. So we'll get to that later, but I just wanted to mention that as well. So there's this Christian family. I don't know if you guys heard of it. There's this very bigoted Christian family. They hate gay people. I mean, just abhor gay people so much that they decided, I mean, they're extremists, obviously, they decided that they were going to leave the United States of America. The name of the family is the Gastonguay family. And they decided that they believed, you know, they were going to leave the United States, which is a government, in their opinion, that supports taxes, abortion, and homosexuality. And so because they're Christian, and because they say Christians today are persecuted because the government won't adhere to their biblical laws that supposedly outlaw gays and bans a woman's right to choose. And so they were also convinced that the government controls the churches because being gay and choosing to have an abortion aren't illegal. So they chose to leave the United States in protest and set course for an island somewhere between Hawaii and Australia called Kiribati or something like that. Anyway, and so they took what they decided to do was to take a leap of faith, as they called it, and put their faith in God and that God would answer their prayers and take care of them because they were on the right side of, you know, of God. And God supported their abhorrence of basically of gay people and homosexuality and of a government that adhered or protected us. And so they decided they would just on a leap of faith get in this boat and go across the fucking ocean from California all the way to fucking Australia. And so they did, and they very quickly got lost at sea, and they remained lost at sea for 91 days. So I think God answered answered their question, really, about homosexuality. During that time, they were like there were squalls coming over the boat and everything, and storms, and the only food they had was honey and juice to subside them. So finally, they were rescued by a fishing boat, and they were transferred. To a Japanese cargo ship, which arrived in Chile 2 weeks later. And then the U.S. Embassy there arranged for them to be flown back here to the United States to Arizona. On the government's dime, by the way, which wouldn't be possible, by the way, without taxes. And, you know, and taxes also pay for the U.S. Coast Guard, which basically kept everybody else informed of where they were and how they were doing and everything else. And so, you know, one thing that taxes do not pay for is abortion. And, you know, all because these people who think that taxes are horrible, gay people are horrible. And they also, for homosexuality and abortion, they're also protected by the Constitution. So anyway, these people are fucking ridiculous. And, I mean, people actually are so convinced that they're quote unquote right about homosexuality being evil and wrong and disgusting. And they take a leap of faith in God, as they put it, and they take themselves across the fucking ocean, the fucking Pacific Ocean, which is fucking huge, and decide to see if God will take care of them because they're on the right side of things. Obviously, they're not. And do you think now that after this has all happened that they now believe, oh, God is telling us that we were wrong. God is telling us that homosexuality is not wrong, that it's just the way he makes people, or that abortion's not wrong, or whatever, that taxes aren't wrong. No, they're going to say, oh, well, God is just trying to teach us a lesson and blah, 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 and testing our faith and whatever. And this is the way people who are highly evangelical believe. They think no matter what happens, God is never to blame, or that if it doesn't somehow reinforce their current beliefs, that somehow it's wrong or not wrong. So it's hard for me to even wrap my head around the way these people think, you know? I mean, they really are quite stupid. I mean, they're just dumb, really idiots. But this is the world we live in today. And people actually agree with people like this, that homosexuality is wrong and that, you know, they wanted to move to some island by themselves. Fine, let them go, for God's sakes. I would be happy, very, very happy, to round up all of the evangelical Christians, excuse me, and have them all go somewhere where they can be their pious selves and you know, believe in whatever they want to believe. Fine. Or even put them in their own state. Go put them in Utah or something, somewhere nobody wants to live anyway, you know, or North Dakota or something. Just put them all somewhere, you know. That way we won't have to deal with their nonsense, and their idiocy won't rule the law of the land. And unfortunately, we have so many fucking politicians. We have so many fucking senators and congresspeople and sometimes presidents, etc., mayors, governors in this country that base their decisions on what? Religion. And you know what? It's fine to be religious. It is fine to have a belief system and a faith. That's fine. I have nothing against that at all. As I've always said, the only time it creates an issue for me is when it involves or interferes with my own personal life. And that is what I get so fucking sick of dealing with. Just leave me the fuck alone and we'll be fine. So anyway, that's something that's happened. And then also Texas, where I live actually, has decided to hear a case which is going to determine whether gay marriage will be is legal or not here in the state of Texas. Well,